So a few days ago, I posted some of the conundrums we have in modern science, including cosmology and quantum mechanics, etc. And one of the biggest conundrums is what we call the cosmological constant problem, which I've mentioned before. And I'm going to just rephrase it right now for you so that we can see why this is such a huge problem in understanding the nature of the universe. So this refers to the vast discrepancy between the observed value of the vacuum energy density and the theoretical value predicted by quantum field theory. The observed value is astonishingly smaller, with estimates suggesting a mismatch of 50 to 120 orders of magnitude. This discrepancy has been described as the greatest and largest discrepancy between theory and experiment in all of science, and the worst theoretical prediction in the history of physics. It implies a fundamental gap in our understanding of quantum physics and general relativity. So that was what I was just reading from my notes. And so when I woke up this morning, I had an email from my friend Menas Kafatos, with whom I wrote the book, You Are the Universe. And as you know, Menas is a theoretical physicist. And he said that right now, scientists are even questioning the existence of dark matter. I've been talking about dark matter, dark light, and I thought I knew what was I was saying, but now even that is being questioned. So there's a scientist by the name of Rajendra Gupta at the University of Ottawa, and he said that there is no such thing as dark matter. And even though modern cosmologists agree that the universe is 13.8 billion years old, based on the Big Bang theory and evidence like cosmic microwave radiation, the theory is being challenged. Rajendra Gupta proposed a new model in 2021, suggesting that the universe is closer to 26.7 billion years old. And some of the key ideas here are, number one, something called tired light. Gupta proposes light loses energy as it travels vast distances, making objects appear younger than their actual age. This tired light would explain why some distant galaxies observed by the James Webb telescope seem more developed than expected for their supposed age in the standard model. So Gupta suggests that the fundamental forces of nature like gravity, electromagnetism, weaken over time. This extended the formation time of galaxies in his model, pushing the universe's age back. So according to him, there's no dark matter. The weakening forces could explain the universe's expansion without the need for dark matter, a mysterious substance yet to be directly observed. So why am I sharing this with you? If you look at the cosmological constant conundrum, the fact that now people don't even agree about dark matter, the fact that the forces of nature over a period of time get weaker, and all the other things I've mentioned before, you know, the fact that there are no laws of physics during the Planck epoch, the precision of cosmic inflation where the universe tripled every trillionth of a trillionth of a trillionth of a second from the size of a dot to the size of a grapefruit, and then slowed down, and now the diameter of the universe is almost 100 billion light years across. None of these things have an explanation. None of these things have an explanation. Even why there was a Big Bang. Where did it occur? Everywhere. Did it contain of all of time? Probably yes. So I was thinking about this, and I thought maybe we've got it all wrong. Maybe all of cosmological science is an explanation where humans are trying to make sense of this, and of this, which sees all of this. Because without this, you can't have the experience of this. And so, what is the explanation? Does the universe need an explanation? It's a human concept, right? Explanation, we try to figure out why things are with the way they are. We impose cause and effect. and we then try and fill in the gaps of our knowledge, but general theory doesn't agree. General theory of relativity, or even the special theory of relativity, does not agree with quantum physics, and now all these cosmological conundrums. So first of all, is any explanation legit? Do we actually need an explanation? Because humans have been coming up with explanations for years, thousands of years. God created the universe. God is a dead white male. Oh no, there are many multiple gods. There was a big bang. I would like to suggest that science is our latest creation myth. And, you know, if it includes some things, some theories include things that work, and then they include things that don't work. Other theories include things that work and include things that don't work. This is because all that we call the universe, including our own body-mind, is a human construct based on language. And now that we have large language models, we can actually come up with multiple theories of the universe, not realizing that these theories are conceived in consciousness. And then after we conceive these theories, we conceive experiments, and then we make observations, and we say we're closer to truth. Actually, the more we know, the further we are from the truth. And all these models of reality are just models of reality. They're maps of reality, and the map is not the territory. What is the territory? Territory is you, me, as awareness, modifying itself as all experience that we call mind, intellect, ego, the five senses, the five subtle senses, and the projection of all that as space-time, energy, information, and matter, and the five elements, space and water and earth and sky and fire and everything that we can conceive, perceive. But that which conceives and perceives is neither perceivable nor conceivable. And that is who we are. The imperceivable having a perceivable experience. The inconceivable having conceptions and explanations. And I don't think the source of creation, the infinite being, needs an explanation. In fact, the infinite being, God, Maya, whatever you call it, or goddess, is the ultimate trickster. Every time you have a model, it's wrong. Then you have another model, it's wrong. And yet these models work. I mean, we have jet planes and intergalactic probes and computers. So why do they work? Because they're all models of a collective dreamscape, and we are the dreamers in the matrix. The whole thing is a magic show. And who's the magician? You are the magician.